No pretty headshots.
Hey, all of us feel like movie stars.
No background checks.
I've done a lot of things that I'm not proud of.
When Hollywood looks for reality, it turns to these guys. From the movie Training Day to NYPD Blue, Mark Brown meets Hollywood's most wanted on Eyewitness News at 11 tonight.
You are about to meet a group of people who were at one time some of the most feared criminals in Southern California. Hardcore gang members who've left the streets but held on to their street smarts. They've gone legit, acting tough for the camera. You could call them Hollywood's most wanted. They look like the people most of us instinctively avoid. Heavily tattooed with hard faces that conjure up disturbing images of drive-by shootings, robberies, and carjackings. Crimes many of these people have committed.
I've done a lot of things that I'm not proud of, you know? But it was just things that I had to do to survive and whatnot, you know?
A familiar face to police and prosecutors, now Noel Guglielmi is after a different sort of notoriety. Here he is in the ABC drama NYPD Blue.
When's the last time you seen Neil Mazur?
Don't know no Neil Mazur. At least by name, anyways.
And the movie Training Day.
Let me check it out, eh?
Guglielmi is a convicted one-strike felon, a former gang member, and an actor. He gets a lot of work thanks to a unique Hollywood talent agency called Suspect Entertainment. Suspect provides real street gangsters as extras and bit players in movies, TV shows, and music videos for acts like Cypress Hill and 50 Cent. It's the brainchild of 30-year-old Manny Jimenez, a 13-year gang member who got out of the street life and talked his way onto a movie set as an extra.
It says the only place I think it could be at where you're not going to be asked if you have a family. They're not going to call your old job and do a background check. It's just like if you show up and you have respect for people, remember your lines, whatever the case may be, you could succeed.
Now he runs the agency, which means, among other things, teaching the basics to people who may have never held a legitimate job in their lives.
Letting them know the ropes. Okay, this is where you go. This is a holding area. You know, don't talk to that person. You can't go talk when they're rolling. You know, you can't talk. Don't go up to Robert De Niro and try to get autographs.
When we go as a group. You know what I mean? We go in and they're looking at us.
Kind of intimidated.
Yeah, they're like, oh, you know, the gangsters are here. You know what I mean? Don't tell them anything because they're going to just hurt us, hit us, do something. They're going to rob us or something.
Do actors like these add to negative media images of young Latinos? You know, you're reinforcing stereotypes. What do you say to that?
Because if they don't cast us, they're going to go get a guy from Hollywood and paint tattoos on him, and they're going to make it happen anyways. They're making money off our image. Why not us be part of that?
The demand for their services is greater than ever, and so are the rewards.
I mean, all of us feel like, you know, movie stars once in a while when we're out there.
But is it right for former criminals to earn a profit, even indirectly, from their crimes? 25-year-old Daniel Venegas served prison time for manslaughter.
I just paroled 10 months ago. I've been doing this about 9 months. It's taking me in a new direction.
Hollywood has always been a place where people with big dreams come in search of a big break. For these unusual suspects, the big break may be just surviving long enough to get here. They also provide lowrider vehicles and bikes and dialogue coaching, and they're always looking for new talent. If you'd like more information on Suspect Entertainment, contact our website at abc7.com. Manny Jimenez, meanwhile, has a bigger goal in mind. Like so many people in the biz, he'd like to direct.